Good afternoon, everyone. Here's Ford Mustang 98 guy. And today's in-depth review, we're going to be taking an in-depth look at the 2013 Toyota Corolla S. Today, I'm going to give you all a full and in-depth walk around of the Corolla. I'm going to start it up. I'm going to show the engine. I'm also going to give you all a full walk around and show you all the interior and the exterior of the car. So, without further ado, let's go ahead and start it up and let it run. The car also has a smart key access system. All you gotta do, make sure you have the key fob with you in your pocket. As you see, it's unlocked. To lock the vehicle, push the button, and after waiting a second, you touch your hand behind the door handle and it automatically unlocks the vehicle. It's a white exterior, black, and I don't know what, black cloth interior. It's got seat covers on it at the moment. It's got a steering wheel cover on it too. Also has push button start as well. All you gotta do is put your foot on the brake, as always, wait for the light to turn green, and hit the illuminated button to start the engine. Fires right up. 3-spoke leather wrapped steering wheel. Very smooth power steering. Horn works. It's very easy to turn too. I believe it's a 4-speed automatic transmission. Low gear selection. Alrighty. Let's flip on the headlights, fog lights, as well as the hazards. Now we'll check out the exterior. Got heated exterior mirrors as well. That chime just went off just to let you know the key has left the vehicle. ''2013 was the last year of this body style until last year. Toyota changed the look of the car. They updated the whole thing. They updated it. It's got pink fog lamps too, if you guys didn't recognize that. Down here you have your standard Goodyear tires. Let's pop the hood. The aluminum door sill's down there. Fucking, it's hot in this car. Coming up to the hood, you have Toyota's 1.8 liter VVTi 4-cylinder. I think this thing's been undercoated, I can tell it. Pops to that. Let's close the hood. Now I'll check out the interior. Power windows, power door locks, window lock there. Storage, full manual driver's seat. Manual tilting steering wheel right there. All right. I got enough gas. Let's give her a couple revs, I guess. Sounds good. Sounds nice. I don't want to rev it too much. You know, it's a new car, so. All right. Let's check out the interior. Down over here, you have your automatic climate control. Jesus, this thing. Right here is your fan speed. Temperature. You can adjust that right there. You have your different modes. Yeah, it works fine. Your circulation, front defrost, rear defrost. You have your off, one-touch automatic. It's all there, you know. Down here. You have a little bit of storage down there. And you have a power outlet right there. Cup holders down there. Here's your radio. AM FM with CD player. Shut the headlights off, I can see it. Sounds good. Here's your setup. You know, it's at a unit screen, so if you'd be able to see it. You have general. We have Bluetooth, and you also, it has Bluetooth telephone as well, so pretty much got everything in here. Phone settings, you know, audio. I don't think there's no backup camera. Let me just check. No, there's no backup camera in this one. Down here, storage down there. Nothing really much to see on this car. You know, it's a Corolla. Cruise control. You have your headlights, fog lights, turn signals there. Wipers down there. You have low speed, high speed. Yeah, it's just sun visors down in the meantime. Over here, you have your temperature, tachometer, speedometer, and gas gauge. And over here is your gear selector. Not bad at all. Manual dimming rearview mirror. You also have your interior lights right there. You also have a power sliding sunroof as well. Or you can even tilt it as well. Storage up there. I like it, you know, it's not a bad car at all. Pretty sporty looking. I don't like it in white though. Over here, your digital clock. And radio controls off to the side here. You also have a USB right there. There, it works fine, yeah. This car is nice, I actually like it. Alright, anyways, I'm gonna... Actually, you know what, I got the keys on me, so we're gonna leave the window down halfway, so I'm gonna lock the key in the car. Check out the back seat. Can't view the trunk, so I'm not gonna open the trunk, because it's a bit dirty in there. Because there's some stuff in the back of the trunk, so your cup holders. Ocean handles. Same right here. Not bad. Can't open the trunk, so I'm just gonna skip that. And I guess that's it. I'll just continue the tour. Trunk's messy, so I can't really get into the trunk.
I like this one. I like the S model. Pretty sporty. Looks pretty sporty.
Doesn't have heated seats though. It's the only thing that's missing. You have your door sills down there. Full manual passenger seat. Same thing on this side. Same deal.
Why is this vent closed?
Down here, you also have two glove boxes right there. You also have the same deal on that side, but I just can't open it. So, alright guys, that's pretty much about it. Put this window back up. Shut her down. Hope you guys enjoyed. Full in-depth review on the 2013 Toyota Corolla S. Stay tuned for my next video. We'll see you next time.